दया करो.
Today's Sikh professional profile is on a Sikh that has found a way to apply his drive and passion for human rights, law and Sikhi to his professional career. Balpreet Singh is born and raised in Canada and legal counsel for the World Sikh Organization, which advocates for the human rights of not only Sikhs, but all Canadians. You may recall recently a group of Sikh lawyers were not allowed entry into the Quebec National Assembly while wearing their kirpans. Balpreet Singh was one of those lawyers. We caught up with him on a recent trip to Vancouver. I'm legal counsel with the World Sikh Organization of Canada. My job has three main parts. The first is legal, dealing with article of faith issues and freedom of religion issues for not just the Sikh community, but all communities. Second is media. If any media needs information about the Sikh faith, or I notice some sort of a trend about the Sikh faith in the media, trying to address that. And finally, education, whether that's for employers with accommodating the Sikh community, or whether it's government letting them know what Sikh issues are. When I graduated from law school, I didn't want to go with a regular law school law career, so I went to a human rights firm called Baker Law. I articled there, and it was mainly human rights cases, but I really wanted to deal with issues in the Sikh community, so when I saw there was an opportunity in the World Sikh Organization, I took it, and I've been there all since, I guess, 2009. My family was a regular Punjabi family, not all too religious, but they did respect Sikhi. My parents had cut hair and my hair was cut as well. But as I grew up, I learned more about the religion and I really grew totally in love with it. I loved what it did for me and I loved what it did in terms of just the spirituality, the identity. And I just ran with it. So in high school I shot Dumrit and ever since then I've been just loving it. When you're wearing a Sikh identity, you're representing more than just yourself. You're representing an entire philosophy, you're representing an entire community. So whatever you're doing, it's not going to reflect just on yourself, it's going to reflect on all of us. And on top of that, people, when they look at you, they're not going to just see you for you. They're going to understand that you represent something more, that you're trustworthy, that they can count on you. So it has a lot of responsibility with it, but it's helped me as far as I can say. The meaning Sikhi gives to you in your life, you can't find that anywhere else. You ask someone, why are you alive? What's the point? And you really don't have an answer. But when you're in Sikhi, you know what you're here for. You know what every day, what your goal is. And inside, you have that feeling. And it's just that feeling, that experience of Sikhi. I mean, it's nothing else. It's the experience. And that's what I love about it.
The kirpan is one of five religious symbols worn at all times. Sikhs can take their kirpans many places, including the House of Commons in Ottawa.
The World Sikh Organization of Canada was invited to Quebec to talk about Bill 94, which essentially restricts services to anyone that covers their face. It's a sideswipe at women that wear the niqab. So even though Sikhs actually are forbidden to wear niqabs or any face coverings, we thought it was an issue that touches on religious freedom. So we went. We were told that you can either take your kirpan off and enter, or you can turn back. And we didn't want to compromise on our principles, so we said, fine, we'll go back even though you invited us. We were really fortunate that the entire national media was on one side this time, whether it's the Globe and Mail, whether it's the Ottawa Citizen, even the National Post, it was all positive. They all said the kirpan is an article of faith, you invited these guys there, why aren't you accommodating them? One thing that we have had trouble with is that even though in our group of four, there were two BBN, there were two Singhs, seems hard to get the message across that BBN also work up on them. People seem to think it's just the Singhs. And actually we were correcting the media over and over again that day and afterwards that no, it's not just men that wear it, it's women. But this has been great, I think, for the kirpan overall in Canada. It's done a lot for the understanding of it. The Sikh youth have so much to be proud of in terms of their heritage. And really the future of the community always lies with the youth. So you need to learn about your faith, and you need to learn how to tell others about your faith as well. On top of that, there's the basics. You can never forget about seva, simran, having sangat. So be proud of it. Don't be ashamed that you're a Sikh. It's something to be so proud of. But that's my main message. Don't shy away from it.
Daya karo baso mane aaye.
Thanks again for joining us on this episode of Ek Onkar TV.
which is brought to you by the Sikh youth at Guru Nanak Sikh Gurdwara. As you've attended various Nagar Kirtans and Vaisakhi events this month, you've probably heard the term Saint Soldier over and over again. Always remember that it's saint and then soldier, but they go hand in hand. As a saint, remember the Guru and connect with the Guru's teaching. As the Guru soldier, share your love and compassion with the world, help those less fortunate than we are, and be a voice for those who do not have one. That's what it means to be a Khalsa. Go Canucks! Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa! Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh!
Love, compassion, and service to humanity are the basic universal principles on which the Sikh way of life was founded. Learn more about your faith and your heritage on Ek Onkar TV, a show for the next generation of Sikhs, bringing you the latest on Sikh issues, music, entertainment, and profiles on professionals and athletes. Coming to you every Saturday at 7 p.m. Pacific and 10 Eastern on Joy TV.